Hey Badminton World, it's Henry and Jeff here from Volant and the Badminton Podcast. We're officially out of lockdown and it's an exciting day because I can do this.
Don't touch me, man.
Sorry. Well, we have a really exciting episode for you today. We are going to talk about whether or not it is the end of Yuta Watanabe's men's doubles career. Jeff?
End? Well, that's a pretty big call.
Yeah, I know. But let's talk through. Let's start with how we heard about Yuta Watanabe first of all. Jeff?
Yeah, so I guess I remember it was 2018, All England. I hadn't heard of him before. Mm. He was playing semi-final against Jiang Nan and Li Yinhui. Hadn't seen him before. Of course, Jiang Nan, right? Like everyone knew Jiang Nan then. Mm. And he just dominated them. And Arisa at the front court was dominating as well. She was just cutting everything off that Jiang Nan was like pushing in the mid court. But I just remember thinking, Yuta was just so smart. And he was so young then, right? He was, what, 20? Yeah, 20 years old, around there, 19. Yeah, 20, 21. Yeah. And he was just finding the gaps in the front court everywhere. And he was just awesome. I remember texting you about him.
That whole week, oh God. It was just, you constantly just like, oh, Watanabe's technique so nice. I'm like, oh, Jeff, shut up. And then I watched some of the matches. I'm like, oh, it's okay. And now I'm absolutely in love with him as well. Cause he's an absolute wizard. It's just, he's just never out of position. He's just always there, always reading the play. Just always seems like he has so much time.
Time and just finding the gaps and just so smart. I remember just thinking he's so young and just so smart. He was like just outsmarting Jiang Nan. Mm. And then he played Zheng Siwei, Huang Yaqiong in the final because that was a semi, right? And then he won that in three straight sets. Sorry, three close sets. Mm. But that's probably the first time I heard of him. And yeah, of course, he was just mixed doubles. I just knew him as a mixed doubles player, kind of just that kind of player there. But I guess from a...
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely a dream run, that sort of like 2018 period for him.
Yeah.
Especially with that particular tournament. Mm-hmm. But he's had some other key results as well. I think before we do that, those that are watching this video don't know who Yuta Watanabe is. Jeff, maybe give him a one-liner so the too long didn't read.
Yeah, 24-year-old Japanese player, doubles specialist. Yeah, mixed doubles, men's doubles, just
bronze
dominated.
Medalist.
Bronze medalist at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. And I guess some key results here. Other than that, world champs, bronze, All England titles twice in both men's doubles and mixed doubles. Mm-hmm. And in men's, he also got the Asian Championship gold, where he beat Marcus and Kevin in the final, and that was an amazing match. So,
yeah. 21-3 in the last game.
Yeah, in the second, just dominated, right? Yeah. So, based on what you think about him now, like you said at the beginning, you didn't really think he was that good, right?
Not so much I didn't think he was that good. I was like, you made him sound so good.
He was.
And when I watched him and I was like, yeah, technique, you said his technique was amazing. And I watched him like, it's good. And now I'm just like, yeah, it's amazing. It is amazing what he brings to the table. But I guess men's doubles, mixed doubles, let's start with the men's doubles because we sort of focused a bit on the mixed already. Look, he's played with Hiroyuki Endo, who recently has retired from the world of badminton.
Yeah.
He's been around for a long time, but their pairing was so good. And from my perspective, it's always been that they were so good at defending and they were both so aware of where each other were. Mm. And Endo had that stability that like a creative player like Watanabe needed in their pairing.
Yeah. I think that creativity really comes into it, especially like with the stop drops and the variation in attack. Now, one thing, he doesn't really have that hard of a smash, which where the drops come in. And I'm actually probably seeing that a lot of the players are starting to read that and be ready for that now. So he's not winning as many points on the stop drops.
Yeah.
But just from a men's doubles perspective, I remember watching him once and just thinking every time they attack to him, like he will never make a defensive error. I know Endo's really, really solid, but I remember just thinking they have to attack to Endo because Watanabe is just not making any errors.
Yeah.
And yeah, just really, really fast. I wouldn't say he's like amazingly fast at the front court, but I think just generally he just takes the shuttle up really, really high, plays really good percentage, smart shots. He doesn't go for crazy shots, but he can create opportunities because he just finds gaps everywhere.
Yeah. I like that, you know, despite under huge amounts of pressure, he will always be able to find a gap. Not put himself into, you know, a risky position. And of course, Endo being the, you know, it's like the, talking about like Naruto, any Naruto anime fans out there, the Sharingan, it's like he knows where everything's going to go as well. So he's able to cover it really well. But yeah, what's interesting is that Endo didn't really have a really big smash as well.
Yeah.
So somehow that pairing just worked.
Yeah. I think just speed and then stability. So speed of Watanabe and then just stability of Endo, experience of Endo. Mm. I'm not sure exactly what happens on the court or behind the scenes, but I don't know whether he's kind of telling him what to do or just guiding him. But I guess from a, if we talk about mixed doubles now with Arisa, like why do you think why do you think Yuta is so good at mixed doubles?
I think, as you said earlier, like he takes everything so early, he gets to everything, he's so aware, he's just always there. And that puts Arisa in a really good position because she is so good in the mid to front court that she's constantly being able to push the front and they're able to get the attack, even though their attack's not that strong, they're both so fast.
Yeah.
And Higashino is very good at finishing the rally as well. So what do you think?
Yeah, I think, similar thing that I said before, just finding gaps and just being really tactically aware of what's happening. And I guess when we talk about when he started picking up men's doubles, because initially we saw him mainly in mixed, and in his playing style, like he's just, in terms of his like physique and his body type, like he's just light. He's just really light on his feet. His footwork's just like really floaty, and he doesn't expend that much energy, it looks like.
Yeah.
So playing two events didn't look like it was that much of an issue. Now, I think that he said, he was interviewed something like that, and he was like, do you think that it's gonna have any effect that you're playing two events? And he's like, no. like I do this all the time. Yeah. I train, like it's not gonna.
It's no different to any other tournament. He's just constantly playing both anyway. Yeah. He's just like an endless source of energy, you know, like he's just jumping around the court constantly and still just not looking fatigued. It's great.
Yeah. So then I guess with the retirement of Endo now, it's gonna be a bit sad. You said, the end of his men's doubles career. I'm not that convinced, but I'm not sure who he's actually going to play with from the Japanese team.
Yeah.
So
I guess the question is whether or not the Japanese team is going to be like, hey, you need to focus on mixed doubles now and just mixed doubles only, or we're going to find you a men's doubles partner out of all very good players.
Yeah.
But Is there one for
Watanabe that's going to sit him? So just in the top, so we've got Matsui and Takuchi.
Yeah.
We've got Koga and Saito.
Yeah.
And we've got Hoki and Kobayashi.
Yeah.
So out of those pairs, like they're all really, really good.
Mm.
But I guess kind of like a typical kind of men's doubles Japanese player is kind of like the Kimura and Tsunoda.
Yeah.
Just fast, solid everything. No one really has like a huge smash or like something that's out of this world crazy, like Kevin Sanjaya's front court or something like that.
Yeah.
Just really, really solid. So out of these players, I'm not sure who would actually suit Yuta's playing style and combine with him. Well, we saw him in Thomas Cup, right? They paired him with Hoki and I think they had a win. They had some losses as well.
Yeah.
But I don't think that's, look, Hoki's solid, but he just doesn't have the firepower or that stability of, say, Endo.
Yeah, I think that pairing with Watanabe and Hoki, if that becomes a pairing, they're not the top. They won't make it to the top of the world. I think they need someone more special, like an Endo that read the game so well, as well as being stable like a Hoki. And like you said, Kimura Tsunoda, it's almost like the five other players are like a watered down and like
they're
version
still
of
really good,
they're still very good,
but just the same style, right?
Yeah, exactly. So where do we find someone that, I think for Watanabe, who needs to be stable but also powerful is what we need for a pairing now for his men's doubles. Which I Kobayashi, think maybe Kobe, yeah, Kobayashi maybe.
Yeah.
But because he is quite creative and not as stable,
yeah,
then it's hard. I think it's a hard pairing, and maybe that's why they haven't put them together.
I do think Kobayashi has something different to the other men's doubles players, but yeah, he's just not that stable. He does make some errors, but does have a bit more firepower. But we haven't really seen a two left-hander men's doubles combination. Oh, I don't even remember when. But for a while, I would say, and whether or not that's a factor as well. So I guess in conclusion, is his men's double career over? What are your thoughts?
I don't think it is. I think they will. Someone will come along. I don't think it'll be from the current selection. I would like them to test Kobayashi with Watanabe, but I don't think the right player for Watanabe to make it to the top is within that team at the moment.
Maybe it's a junior coming up or someone coming through the ranks that we haven't really heard of yet. But I would probably say the same. But I think that, until they find that person, it will be very much a mixed doubles focused thing. I think he's still the best men's doubles player there.
Yeah.
Out of the whole group, even though he's more focused on mixed doubles.
Yeah.
So, like I said, I think a bit of a waste if they don't use him, but
yeah, I agree.
Got to use him right. Okay. Well, that has been our discussion on what's next for Yuta Watanabe. We'd love to know what you think, so make sure you comment below because, this is just our opinion and hopefully we do see him on court dominating again because we're really big fans. So, as we said at the start, I'm Jeff, this is Henry here. We're really happy to bring you this show and we'll see you on the next one.
See you, everyone.
Bye.